Good morning, boys. Today I'm going to explain experiment number 3 to class 9, right? Now the aim of this experiment is to study the relationship between the square of the time period t square and the length of the simple pendulum L. That means we'll be studying the relationship between t square and L of a simple pendulum. The formula used here will be t is equal to 2 pi under root L by g. L is a length, g is the acceleration due to gravity, and t is the time period of the simple pendulum. For using the time period here in this particular experiment, we'll be making more use of this particular formula, the second formula. T is equal to t by 10, where t is the time period for the simple pendulum. T is the time taken for 10 oscillations of the simple pendulum. And here 10, I have shown that there are number of oscillations taken are 10. The apparatus used are going to be a metallic ball suspended with an inextensible and weightless string which serves as a simple pendulum. To take one oscillation of the pendulum, we'll be making the pendulum move from the mean position to the right hand side. The pendulum comes back to the mean position, moves to the left and comes back to the original position. This will be counted as one oscillation. Because it's difficult for the boys or the students to count from the middle, they can forget whether they have to count from the left hand side or the right hand side. So what we do? We take one extreme point while taking the readings with the help of the simple pendulum. So I can choose one of the corner and I take the movement of the pendulum here and coming back, that will be one oscillation. Moving again, the second oscillation, and so on. I can keep on counting the number of oscillations while doing the experiment. So for this experiment, what exactly we are going to do? We'll be using this observation table, and in this observation table, I have to take 5 different sets of observations by changing the length of the pendulum from 50 cm to 60 to 70, 80 and 90. I'll be taking the 50 cm length first of all and then make the pendulum oscillate for 10 times, right? 10 oscillation time I'll be taking and note it down below the heading small t, which has been written in second. So small t has been represented for time taken by the simple pendulum for 10 oscillations. Now in the first reading, let's suppose the reading comes out to be 14.6 seconds. Then in the next column, it's written time period is equal to t divided by 10. So I can directly also I can calculate, dividing by 10 is easier. So my reading comes out to be 1.46, because 14.6 divided by 10 gives me 1.46. Now in the last column, I'll be taking the square of the time period, and the unit used will be second square. If I find the square of 1.46, approximately the value comes out to be 2.1. So I need the length, time for 10 oscillations, time period and square of the time period. These readings I need. I'll repeat my experiment by changing the length of the pendulum to 60 cm and again find the time for 10 oscillations and take the time period and find the square of it, and so on. That means I have to take 5 set of reading for different lengths. Now once I've taken all the observations, then I'll be doing the calculations. Now for the calculation, one of the calculation I've explained to you here, time period is equal to small t divided by 10. So the first reading I've used, 14.6 here, divided by 10, which gives me 1.46 as an answer. I'll take the square of this time period, 1.46 square of it, and approximate answer comes out to be 2.1 second square. If I take all the readings and the square of all the time periods, then I have to plot at the end a graph between the length of the pendulum and square of the time period. So length from here and square of the time period from here. So I'll keep on taking the readings from this observation table and I'll keep on plotting. While putting the readings, I can get 5 points. Now let's suppose while I plot the graph, I get these 5 points, right? In my graph, I read the values and I find my 5 points have appeared like this. I have to join the best 3 points to make it into a straight line. So what I do? I join the points which are coming in the line. That means these 3 points I have joined to make it into a straight line. Thereby saying the result that time period square is directly proportional to length of the simple pendulum. And this result I'll be writing over here in the statement form that square of the time period is directly proportional to length of the simple pendulum. And that's the basic relationship what we wanted to know. Now coming on to the basic explanation how actually you're going to perform your experiment. So what we'll do, we'll take this stand and we have been given a pendulum suspended with the help of a string, right? So I'll use this ruler and I'll try to measure the length of the pendulum by taking the length from half of the bob, and the first reading I'll be measuring it up to 50 centimeter, right? I'll be putting up to 50 centimeter mark, and once the 50 centimeter mark I measure, right, I'll be putting my thumb over here and make sure that it is from half, because from the center of gravity up to the length whatever has been subscribed. Now this pendulum, now I'll be suspending it on the stand, close the knob, right, and the extra thread you're going to keep it behind so that it doesn't disturb your reading. Now while taking the reading, you can start the pendulum oscillating, or while taking the time you can make it start. Either you keep it oscillating and then start your stopwatch, or you can start your stopwatch here and start the pendulum. So what I'm doing, I'm making it move slowly and I'll be using a stopwatch for measuring the time, and I release it softly and I start my stopwatch. 1, 2, 3, so on. I'll keep on counting. So choose one of the corner, and from one of the corner you will start the timing, and then when the pendulum comes back to the original position, that is going to be the one count. And that way you will be counting the time for 10 oscillations. And these 10 oscillations time you are going to write in the column small t, right? Now for your second reading, again remove the pendulum and measure the length and increase its length from 50 to 60 centimeter, fix it again and take your reading again, right? So I'm repeating it. From the corner you'll start the stopwatch and release it softly. Don't make it move from further distance, because otherwise the jerks are going to come. So there should not be any jerks in the movement of the pendulum. This should move softly. So I'm releasing it again and I'll start my stopwatch. 1, 2, and so on. So this way again you'll be counting the number of oscillations and take the time for those 10 oscillations by making use of a stopwatch, right? And at the end, by doing all the observations, you'll be writing the result with the help of the graph you have plotted.